having us.
Of course. So,
where to start?
Tell me.
You guys have a new album called Purple. Before you went through, you know, Red, Blue, Yellow and Green, mm-hmm. and before releasing Purple, are you aware that your fans were thinking you were releasing those named after Pokemon editions?
No, I did not know that.
That's a piece of trivia, right?
There. I didn't know. I thought for a minute that there was a theory that there's this book in the U.S. called it's by Shel Silverstein, I think. It's called One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue Fish. Because we did first EP, second EP.
Right, yeah. Remember,
so that was another one. Well, no Pokemon.
No Pokemon. Okay, thank you. So every one of those has a distinct sound, obviously. Mm-hmm. What comes first? Is it the mood and the music, or is it the idea for the color, some sort of inspiration for that inspires you to create the music? What comes first?
The music comes first. Yeah.
The music
always
comes first?
Yeah.
Okay. And so what is Purple to you?
Purple's just a little snapshot of the year and a half that we spent writing and recording it. It's okay. Just about the experiences that mm-hmm. we went through, and you know, the things that the music exhibits all the qualities of those things that inspired us over the course of that time.
Mm-hmm. So the color choice, is it like synesthesia in a way?
In a way, yeah. I mean, and similarly, it's also just a simple album title.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great. Is there any more concepts you would like to explore in the future aside from the colors? Is there anything else that comes into mind when you hear the music?
I mean, there's a lot of things that come to mind when I hear our music, but concerning concepts and how they shape or direct an album, we don't spend too much time thinking about that before we write,
mm-hmm.
because it's more genuine when we're able to write something without thinking about it.
Yeah, right.
Those are better songs. It's a better way to write, I believe.
Okay, great. Can you talk a little about the album art and the inspiration for the imagery? Because that's your work as well.
It's sort of the same thing. It's I had to figure out a way to visually depict a great wealth of experiences that happened over the course of, you know, a relatively short period of time. Maybe a year, maybe a year and a half.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to relay them in a way that paid respect to the music and the lyrics and the concept of the overarching concept of the album, but that also had elements that were personal, Ellen, and as well as elements that I thought were essentially universal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, something that anybody, any casual viewer or listener could pull something from.
Purple is not your most poppy album, obviously, but it is arguably, I don't think so.
Okay.
It is arguably the best critically acclaimed album. But what has been the reaction of the fans on this tour, maybe?
They're going bananas.
Yeah?
Yeah, because we are. We're excited. They're excited. The level of energy is reciprocal. It's like a circuit. So the more excited we are, the more excited it feels like our fans get, and the more excited they get, the more excited we get. And it just keeps going round and round until, an hour, 45 minutes, 2 hours into a set, we're just completely dead, you know, because we've given right. out everything that we have.
And so talking about your most poppy album, for me that would be Yellow and Green, maybe probably more Yellow than Green. After the years, how do you see it now?
Well, I see it now as I've always seen it. We needed then, as we need with the beginning of each record, to do something different and to hold ourselves to a higher standard of quality and to try and make an attempt to write music that's more genuine and earnest and direct. With Yellow and Green, we were trying to, you know, broaden our horizons, so to speak, musically, and use a great variety of volumes and tempos and structures to see what we were capable of. Because otherwise, we would have just rewritten something that sounded exactly like Blue, and that wasn't interesting. That was boring.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you wouldn't say that Purple is trying to get back to the more compact, raw yet still catchy sound of Red and Blue. It's just another phase, another chapter.
Yeah. To me, the way we wrote music during Red and Blue is completely different than the way we wrote music for Purple. So it's in my heart and in my mind and to my ears, it sounds entirely different than those two records. Would never, ever, under any circumstance, take a step backwards musically.
Okay. Why did you pull a double release back then? Why not two shorter albums? Or one?
Because if we had released one and then had to wait on the songs that we had to release the second, I felt like we would have probably thrown some of them mm-hmm. away.
So was it just a lot of music flowing and
it was like,
going with it?
In the States we say, you go to air out your laundry, and we had a lot of laundry, so to speak, to air out. We had a lot of things that we needed to say, and it felt important to say them as they happened all at once, even though it didn't make sense.
The journey to Purple has uh-huh. been rocky because of that, because yep. of the bus crash, because of the lineup changes. But still, the album came out and it sounds incredibly cathartic, positive, and optimistic, I would say.
Yes.
Does that reflect your personal journey?
If we're writing songs correctly, it does, yeah. I mean, if our intent is to take the things in life that we struggle with, or the things in life that we can't quite articulate with words, that we can't quite deal with in a different way, and use music to express those thoughts, therefore address them and move past them, then yes, I think that's exactly what we've done.
Okay.
If that's how you interpret the record, then yes.
I do.
That is how I interpret the record. So, for me, the most successful moment of the record is the one time that I get to listen to it the first time. And then everything after that is, that's for everybody else. But there's one listen I get that tells me whether or not we've been successful. And that comes before anything's sold or anything's marketed or anything's toured on or anything like that. And it's that first pure listen that you get.
The production on your albums is usually very colorful, textural, rich, and complex. How does it all start? Does it start with a very clear vision about the final product, or do you just go with it and experiment with gear and etc.?
Yeah, I mean, it starts with a pretty clear idea of what would work. We record demos of our songs and listen to them and critique them and add layers to them, and then once we've got things that we know will work, then we record and we see what actually does work. In a way that is more fully realized than we're capable of as a four-piece, because we've invited a producer in to add his or her opinions and ideas and textures on top of that. And in order to do that, you have to be confident with whom the person you're working with, but you also have to be confident enough in your own material to say, I believe, or we believe, that this music is good enough that somebody else can add their opinion to it, and we can maybe improve it somehow. But there is always room in a recording studio to let something change and something get modified. You can cut things out, you can add things. There really aren't rules. The only limitations that you have as a recording artist are the limitations of your creative imagination. Is whether or not you choose to take a Spartan, straightforward, very clean and simple approach, or something that's more complicated and layered. And we typically like to layer things because it's interesting.
Right. So a little bit of both,
yeah.
Both vision and experimentation.
Yeah, you have to be open-minded enough to adapt at any point in time. Including. After you've recorded it. It has to be able to change on stage.
There seems to be a quite interesting music scene around where you started, Savannah, Georgia.
Mm-hmm.
Quite a lot of well-known bands in, you know, these underground circles
right.
come from there. What was it like to start there?
You know, we lived in a town and we had friends in bands and we were trying to mutually, you know, outdo one another creatively and in a positive way and help each other. And, you know, that environment bred, you know, a whole lot of creativity and you know, quite a few great albums, in my opinion.
Sure.
So, I don't know how that stacks up against anybody else because that's where I lived for 11 years. You know, that's all I knew.
And then you moved to Philly, right?
Yeah, I moved to Philly.
Right. And I've heard, yeah, I meant you personally, and I've heard that you did some solo shows, maybe around the time where Yellow&Green was in the works or something. Maybe
it was right after Axe and when I was trying.
Yeah, it's called Kelly, etc.
Yeah.
What did you take from that experience, which is obviously way different from playing with the band?
Well, from every experience, and it's not intrinsically, it's not very different. It's a little more exposed. But any time that, as a musician, any time that you get an opportunity to do something different and challenging that holds, that forces you to, you know, really push your skills forward, you should take it, you know, regardless of whether or not you're good at it. It's a great learning experience, you know, both playing with a band and playing without. It all adds up to... you know, for as a musician, to learning new ways to present music.
Would you ever consider working with that stripped back setting?
I do. Yeah, I have done it, and I will continue to. There's nothing conceptually that's off the table ever, and that's, you know, that's an important thing to note. I don't see the point in ever sticking to one path. I think you should always have multiple directions that you can go.
So in 2 years, the band is going to be 15, right? Uh-huh. If I'm counting correctly. Is there any idea for any sort of special release, maybe like a box set or something? Something or your fans could...
It hasn't ever come up, but you know, we're always interested, regardless of the anniversary, in offering new and special releases. And I think I'm sure we will do something. I'm sure at some point we'll take Purple and repackage it and use all of the material that we had to put it together, which, you know, didn't make it into the current edition. So yeah, I guess the answer is yes, but not because we'll turn 15, just because we do what we want to do, you know, what we want to do.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think that's all. So thank you for the interview and have a great, you know, time on the road.
There, yeah.
Safe.
It'll be good.